Good day. Welcome back to another week of Talking Technical. And as always, let us kick off with some nice requests. I mean, we've got an amazing market in the Americans, the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, the NASDAQ. They don't even think about going down. I mean, they don't even know that there's a day that they must go red. It's every day green. And it doesn't matter who shoots who and who wants to kill. It doesn't matter, it goes up. But I'm afraid one day that market is going to really surprise you and really be very, very nasty. Well, let's have a look at the Sutrix Fini. Somebody asked about the Sutrix Fini. What do I think about the chart? And let's have a look here. If we look at the chart here, Sutrix Fini, beautiful rally, a lamp pole formation here, straight to the top. I mean, nothing could stop that market. And all the banking shares participated in this rally. I mean, it just went up one way. But unfortunately, this is a lamp pole formation and there's two tiny little gaps here. Let me give it through to you. The one is sitting at, let's just get the RAND chart here, sorry. The one is sitting at 1845, unfortunately, 1845, and that gap will close at 1843. And then the other gap sits between 1779 and 1769. I mean, lamp pole formation, and everybody will say, France, but don't you see the lamp flag formation here? Let's just have a look. There's the flag formation. I actually want to pull it in for you guys. There you are, beautiful support there on the gap. There's the flag formation. And everybody will say, France, but a flag formation usually go up. Now, that's 100% sure. But one thing is for sure, if this support line breaks, then things can really turn upside down. So the big level to watch here is 1904. If 1904 can turn into a resistance, we can close this gap. I gave you the levels, and you can even see this gap close. And if things really get nasty, there's another gap here, and that gap, and there's another gap. But I think our first target will be to close this gap. And that gap sits between 1779 and 1769. So for those guys that wants to buy, I think maybe you're late. Let's wait for a pullback. Look at my stochastic. My stochastic is in no man's land. And can you remember Dr. Clive Roffey? He always say only participate when it's really stretched to the bottom or to the upside. So be a little bit careful. I think the Sutrix Fini had a beautiful, strong rally. Let's have a look at Goldfields. Somebody asked about Goldfields Limited. And I'm sure that person wanted to buy the share or sell the share. We don't know. Unfortunately, he didn't give it to us. But let's have a look at Goldfields South Africa. I mean, look at this rally. This share had one beautiful rally. I can remember we called a short year after this lamp pole formation for our clients or new subscribers. And look what happened. It fell all the way through the cliff. And now it went up all the way. But what worries me a little bit is the following. Look at that. There's a high at around 359. And now we're at 295. That's almost 60 rand lower. But what makes me a little bit worried is that although we see this beautiful rally, but it's lower than that one. That makes me nervous. And look at your stochastic. Your stochastic is sitting at a 76, not far from being overbought once again. So be a little bit careful and look at this candle. This candle worries me. This is like a shooting star. There's a tiny little hanging man there, but nothing has been confirmed as yet. But where's this sign here? The big level there to watch is just below that 50-day moving average. Be a little bit careful. That 50-day moving average sits at 286.26. Below 286.26. Things can really turn upside down. We can maybe see the share to pull back. And of course, we've seen this. If gold shares rally to the top, always a strong move. When it starts to fall, a strong move. Be careful. I see even Harmony at one massive rally, but it also looks like there's a tiny little bit of a lower high developing there. But I mean, look at Goldfields. Strong rally. And what do I see? I'm a little bit nervous at this line, but it's way too early to talk about this because all the gold bulls will say France, but that's a long way from here. Look at this. There's a left shoulder. There's the massive head. There's a right shoulder developing. I'm a little bit nervous on this right shoulder because this right shoulder will start to show its first face below 286.26. And unfortunately, look at this. Below this neckline, that neckline sits at 248.08. It's almost unbelievable that you can think that these shares can come down all the way to there. But what will happen then? If that's the case, we can see two targets. The one is the full target. Let's just show you where it can go to. Can you believe it? A share like Gold Fields can really show you some move down all the way. That's on the full target, 159.24. And if we look at the conservative target, I really hope I'm wrong, because gold shares are at the moment big in demand. That can take you all the way down to 213 Rand and 37 cents. Well, let's have a look at Tiger Brands. Well, there you are. Tiger Brands, one of the stars of the market, just goes higher. Nothing can stop the share. I mean, it's a food share. We always say that inflation is coming down. But unfortunately, if I look at this chart, it looks like that the share is going up. And what do we see here? We see an inverse head and shoulder developing here. And look at that. You can almost see there's the left shoulder. There's the big head. There's the right shoulder. And we're on the brink of turning this into a support. And of course, above 215.61. We can easily see the share ticking higher. And what is your targets? Let's just do that quick one because our time is running out here. And there's your head all the way. Let's take the full target there. It's almost at the same spot because the head and the right shoulder is not too far from each other. But there you are. The conservative target, 224.34. Full target, 229.15. But then you need to buy at 215.28. Make use of a stop loss. There's your stop loss of 205.11. But I'm a little bit nervous. Look at this candle. Ach, this gap there. That gap shows that there's some upward momentum. But just be a little bit careful if this gap closes. And this gap sits between 202 and 232. That makes me a little bit nervous. But I mean, still a beautiful inverse head and shoulder here. Beautiful chart. It can easily move higher. Just be a little bit careful. It already had a massive rally. I mean, some of these shares, look at it, a few months ago, it was 155. Now it is 215. Let's have a look at Zeder, another food company. And then we can easily see what this share is showing us. Zeder. I just want to draw in that line there. Zeder. In a consolidation phase, not as strong as Tiger Brands. I'm a little bit nervous because it looks like there's an ugly candle here. Look at this ugly bearish engulfing candle. There's my support. While the support is on the go, I'm happy with the chart. But where will this chart start to worry? Below 1.81. And there's your 50-day moving average. 1.80. And guys, look at this. The share is, or ladies even, sorry, guys and ladies, there's the share overbought. So we can easily see that it can pull back to the stochastic right to the bottom. And be careful. There's your level to watch. Just be a little bit worried because this market, in essence, had one beautiful rally. Let's have a look at Sappi. I mean, one of those stars of the market. I know people love it. It's a commodity play. I just want to get it there. Sappi. Let's have a look here. I'm a little bit nervous already on this share. You can see I did some work on that already. And there you are, Lample formation, lower high, overbought, makes me a little bit nervous. Where will be my first sign of weakness? It will be on that 50-day moving average. Be a little bit careful. Below, there's the level. Below, there you are, 52.44. It can easily go lower. Maybe if you want to sell, take profit below 52.44, but as always, if it gets above 54.22, we can reach for this gap to the top, and that gap sits between 5.563. and that will only close at 5, 6 and 10. Well, thank you for your time. And remember, Forsberg is one of the finalists of the Town of the Year. So if you want to join us, vote for us. Just SMS us 55137 to SMS, and you just put in Forsberg and you vote for us till Friday. Let's see you. All the best. Have a nice day and visit our website www.fransdeclare.com for more info. And as always, we will chat again.